Jeremiah, the 6th chapter, and again, the 16th verse, it says, thus saith the Lord, stand ye in the ways and ask for the old paths. Where is the good way? See? Or in other words, where's the good doctrine? This is what you should be inquiring. See? Reading on, it says, and walk therein, meaning subscribe to it. Once you find out the good way or the good doctrine, you are to walk therein. See? It says, and ye shall find rest for your souls. So again, whatever path you have embarked on, whatever way you have taken, you got to remember there's a destination. Your destiny lies ahead. And again, for those of you who subscribe to this form of teaching, which is framed as the words of eternal life, as the doctrine of immortality, then this means your destination, see, your destiny is rest. Let's read this again. It says, where is the good way, and walk therein, and ye shall find rest for your souls. See? But they said, we will not walk therein. And pursuing to the book of Isaiah, the 59th chapter, it tells you how the 2/3 of our people have made themselves crooked paths. See? And whomsoever shall walk therein would not find peace. See? So your destiny all hinges on whatever path you have embarked on. See that? Which brings me right here. To the book of Ezekiel, the 7th chapter, and starting at the 1st verse, it says, moreover, the word of the Lord came unto me, saying, also thou son of man, thus said the Lord power unto the land of Israel. Yeah, and this will apply to you so-called Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans. Wherever you might be, wherever you have been driven out and scattered to, you got to remember Israel is a people before it's a place. So pretty much this word has now begun to accomplish what it was set out to do. You know, and besides the obvious condemning the so-called white man, which pursuant to the book of Ezekiel, the 35th chapter, we was commanded to prophesy against Mount Seir, but also this word was set to go out to Israel. And that's the time we're in. We're in a time where this word has pretty much rested and settled on the hearts and minds of you so-called Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans. This Israelite thing, this Hebrew Israelite thing, is the new topic, man. It dominates the conversation of you so-called Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans. See? So this word has accomplished what it was set out to do. And now there's no more cloak for your sins, because you have heard the word, see? Again, it says, also, thou son of man, thus said the Lord power unto the land of Israel. See, and again, Israel is a people before it's a place. It says, and in, the end is come upon the four corners of the land. So wherever you might be, if you're an Israelite, your end is approaching. See, whatever path you have embarked on, you're reaching your end. You're reaching your destination. Your destiny lies ahead. See, verse 3. Now, see, now is the end come upon thee, and I will send mine anger upon thee, and will judge thee according to thy ways, see, and judge thee according to thy ways. And again, that word way, and the symbolic meaning of it, or whenever you come across the word path, right, it translates to whatever philosophies, ideas, or overall doctrines you subscribe to, man, see? It says, and will recompense upon thee all thine abominations, and mine eye shall not spare thee. Yeah, and this is concerning the time that's fast approaching, the time which the scriptures have coined as Jacob's trouble. See? It says, and mine eye shall not spare thee, neither will I have pity, but I will recompense thy ways upon thee. See? And thine abomination shall be in the midst of thee, and ye shall not, Selachia, and ye shall know that I am the Lord. Verse 5, thus said the Lord power, and evil, and only evil, behold, is come, and end is come, the end is come, it watcheth for thee. See, it watcheth for thee, behold, it is come. So your end, or your destination, if you will, to whatever path you have embarked on, is waiting on you to get there, man. See that? And again, we know, those of you sincere brothers and sisters alike, who have subscribed to these teachings, which translate to you walking a certain path. Well, if you continue in that path, then your destination would be salvation. But for any of you outside of this circle and whatever path you have embarked on, well, guess what? Your destination is destruction, man. See? So now, with that said, where are these ways, these paths, which again translates to ideals, philosophies, and overall doctrines found? Well, right here in America, Babylon the Great. And that's outlined right here in the book of Proverbs, the second chapter, and the 18th verse. It says, for her house inclineth unto death. Yeah, and this her right here is concerning America. See, again, for her house inclineth unto death, and her paths, see, and her paths unto the dead. And again, those paths are symbolic to whatever doctrine you subscribe to. So, whatever way you have taken, whatever path you have embarked on outside of the path of righteousness and the doctrine that leads to everlasting life and immortality, well, guess what? The destination of that path is destruction. Pretty much death awaits. So, yeah, I just wanted to touch on that, Lord willing. It was edifying. Till the next time I say shalom.